My name is Niels Moerke, and I'm one of the owners of Van Ozane and Neva Architects. At Van Ozane, we design yachts and vessels with a specific aim in performance. The founding father of the company, Peter Van Ozane, has a great heritage in the America's Cup scene. Actually, he was involved in Australia too, who was the winner of the America's Cup in 1983. At Van Ozanen we have three disciplines, CFD, which is the knowledge about flows around vessels, naval architecture, the technical design of vessels, and engineering, the link between naval architecture and the yards, how to build vessels. And we spend about 20% of our men and girl power on research and development. We were very excited when Hutting actually approached us for the new design of the Hutting 46. We know Hutting from safe vessels, ocean-going vessels, cruisers, which can travel everywhere, and they were looking for a yacht with a bit more performance. And for us as being hydrodynamicists, technicians, sailors, it was actually the sweet spot of a design we would love to work with. Soon after we received the assignment from Hutting, we started working on the ocean-going sailing vessel for long-distance cruising, but also increasing the performance of the yachts. And we are very thrilled, actually, with the result. We've seen the yacht already hitting the water and sailing, and we were really proud and thrilled by the result. She's a real performance long-distance cruiser, the aim we had in mind. What we aim for the Hutting 46 is to find an optimal combination for safety, comfort and performance, and that relates to the stern of the vessel. So we have a specific shape for optimizing that specific design goal. This is also why we use a bit narrower stern than compared to really modern racers. Specifically for the Hutting 46, we designed two keel configurations. We have the deep keel or the long keel, and we have a shallow keel, and the shallow keel uses winglets and a trim tab as an option to optimize the actual performance. And the aim in the end is to have the same performance using the shorter keel with winglets equal to the longer keel without winglets. Another important design point, how the vessel steers, and with that the interaction with the actual keel and rudder is really important, because there's a flow coming over the keel downwards to the rudder. And if we want the vessel to be in balance, we need to study how we can influence this flow positively. Basically, what we see here is two equal yachts. So we have two configurations for the Hutting 46, one with a deeper keel, one with a shallow keel. So both serve a certain goal in sailors, one for more shallow water, coastal waters, exploring maybe a bit more, and this is more for performance. What we see actually is, if we compare the performance, is that it is really close. So if you look to VMG, velocity made good, upwind, we see that the deep keel is equal performing as the shallow keel. And that is the main benefit for the owner in the end, that it's independent of choice of keel how the vessel will perform. Another specific design aspect for the Hutting 46 is the longer coach roof, which you see on the design. During the design, safety and seaworthiness was an important design parameter. So we choose for a relatively deep foreship, so a V, in order to improve seaworthiness and comfort on board. And with that, we needed some height, and we integrated the longer coach roof in order to facilitate good standing heights and safety within the same design. We know for sure that the result of this design is a very successful yacht, which will be much appreciated by the sailing public who knows Hutting and who will learn to know Hutting as well.